Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Solid Master. Today we are going to analyze a new problem which is a stress analysis of rectangular L bracket. So this is the L bracket. Here if you see that this two bracket is given. The first one is the horizontal bracket, horizontal rectangular bracket, and this in one is the second one is the vertical rectangular bracket. And the dimension is given, dimension is also given, the width of the first rectangular is given 150 mm, and the here also the second rectangular width is given 50 mm, and the height of the second rectangular plate is given 100 mm, and the height of the first rectangular plate is given 50 mm. So this is the thickness of this rectangular plate is given, that is 10 mm. And here if you see that at this is our the origin point, center one is the origin point, through origin point two coordinates is passing, that is horizontal one is the x coordinates and the vertical is our y coordinates. So we have to use these coordinates in ANSYS mechanical APDL to solve this type of problem. So if you see that here is two circle is given, and this circle is the is for the pin support, circular hole is for the pin support, and in this plate the total load is given, that is 10 kN. 10 kN is acting on this plate at downward directions. And if you see that here two values is also given, Young's modulus is given in 200 GPa. So we have to convert this gigapascal into megapascal, because all the dimension is given in mm. So we have to convert this in megapascal. That is, if you convert this megapascal, so it will be 200 into 10 raised to 3 megapascal. And the Poisson ratio is given, that is 0.3. So now we will solve this problem in ANSYS mechanical APDL. So let's start with our new problems. So we have I have opened the ANSYS mechanical APDL. This is the APDL interface. Now we will first give the preference. So our preference will be structural, and click on OK. Now we will give the click on the preprocessor, then element type, then add edit. We have to add the element, click on add, and if then we will click on solid, and here select the quad 4 node 182, and then click on OK. Now click on the options. In options, because if you see that in question there is given a thickness also, so in this element behavior here we will select the plane stress with respect to thickness. So this is the plane stress with respect to thickness, and then click on OK, and then close. Now in question, if you see that the thickness is given, that is 10 mm, so in the plate we have to give the thickness, so real constant is used for giving the thickness. So click on real constant, then add, then here add, OK, then thickness will be our 10 mm, then click on OK, then close. So thickness is added. Now we have to create a material models. So we have to give the Poisson ratio in a model, Young's modulus. So for creating this we have to use the material properties, then go to materials models, in this click on structural, go to linear, elastic, isotropic. Here Young's modulus should be our 2E5, so we have converted in megapascal, and 20 we are converted at this, so it will be 2 into 10 raised to 5. So here we instead of writing 10 raised to 5 in ANSYS, we have to write the e raised to 5, and poison ratio will be 0.3. Now click on OK. So our both Young's modulus and poison ratio is added. Click on close. Now we have to create two rectangles for this. So for creating the rectangles, we will go click on the modeling, then here click on create, then areas, then we have to create the rectangle and select the by two corners. So first we will create the first rectangle. So this is the first horizontal rectangle we are creating. If you see that our x value here will be the 0 and y value will be also 0 and width will be our, this is the width starting from this origin point, that is 150 mm, and height will be for this rectangular plate will be 50 mm. So we will add this. So x will be 0, y will be 0, and width will be 150. And height will be 50 mm. And click on apply. So this is the first rectangular plate. Now we have to create one second rectangular plate below this first rectangular plate. So if you see that in second vertical rectangular plate, so our x will be, this is the origin point. So this one is the origin point because at this origin our second vertical rectangular plate is started. So this will be 50. So our x value will be 150 minus 50 mm, and y will be our same 0, and width will be for this rectangular plate, width will be 50 mm, and height will be, this is the height, that is 100 mm, because this second vertical is acting downwards from the first vertical from the first horizontal rectangular plate. So we will write that height will be minus 100 mm. So our x value will be, we calculated that 150 minus 50 mm, and y will be our same 0, and width will be for second rectangular will be 50 mm, and height is acting towards downward at below the first rectangular plate, so it will be minus 100 mm, and click on OK. So this is the second rectangular plate as in added. If you see that this two rectangular plate is separate, so we have to add these two elements. This one is the first and second element, we have to add this. For adding this both the elements, go to operate sections. Here is the operate, then boolean, then click on add. Then we have to add this both this area. Click on area. Now we have to select the first rectangle and second rectangle first. Second, and then we will click on OK. So if you see that this line is hidden, that means both these elements are added and formed a single elements. Now we will create these two circles. First circle acting at the first rectangle horizontal rectangular plate, and second circular will be acting at in the vertical rectangular plate. And the coordinates for this circle, first circle will be at x will be equal to 0 because it is starting at the origin. So x and y will be 0. So x will be 0. Now, y is not 0 because dimension is given for y. So y is acting in these directions. So y will be 50 divided by 2 and radius will be 50 by 2. This is the total diameter will be given. Diameter is 50, so radius will be half of the diameter, that is 25. So three values are known, x value is 0, y value will be at this center point, this one will be the y value. So y value will be 50 divided by 2 and radius will be the half of the diameter, that is 50 by 2. So for adding the circle, then again go to create, then areas, then here circle, then solid circle, then x will be our 0, y will be 50 divided by 2 and radius will be 50 divided by 2 and click on apply. So this first circle is added. We have to add another circle. For this we have to do the coordinates value. So this for adding the second circle, so x will be our, so our second circle will be started at this center point of the circle. So this one is the center from here. So if you calculate this, this is already 100, this is already 100 and this one is the 50. So we will do 100 plus this one is the 50. So 50 divided by 2 will be 25. So 100 plus 25 is the x coordinates value. And y coordinates will be, y is acting downwards. So y will be the minus 100 and radius of this second circular plate will be 50 divided by 2 because the circle is in the diameter. So diameter is 50 mm. So radius will be 50 divided by 2. So we have known the three coordinates value. X value will be 100 plus 50 divided by 2, that means 100 plus 25, because the second circle will be acting and the centroid will be the center one. So here the second circle will be added, so that is why 100 plus 50, 25. And y will be acting downward, so it will be minus 100. And radius will be 50 divided by 2. Then click on OK. So we have added this two circle in the rectangular L brackets. Now we have to add these two circles, or we have to combine these three elements. First element, this is the second element and third element. For combining these three elements into single elements, again we will click on the operate, then booleans, then add, then in areas, click on this area, then select the three elements, that is first circle, rectangle and the second circle, and click on OK. So these three elements are added into single elements. Now we have to create one circle here. This circle we have to create in the rectangular bracket, and then we have to subtract this circular holes for the pin support. Here question, in this question it is given circular hole for pin support. So for creating these circles, again we have to give the three coordinates value, that is x value will be 0, y value will be 50 divided by 2 because at the center circle is to be created, and radius will be, so circle diameter is 25, so radius will be half of the diameter, that is 25 divided by 2. So again click on the create, then areas, then in area section there is circular and solid circular, then x will be our 0 and y will be 50 divided by 2 because it is acting at the center, circle will be acting at the center, and radius will be 25 divided by 2, and then click on apply. First circle is added. Now for adding the second circle, let's discuss the three coordinates value for adding the three circle. So our x value will be, this circle is acting at the center, so here this is the center point of this x value. So this is the total is the 100 from this point to the this point, it will be 100, and the center will be, this total will be 50. So 50 divided by 2 will be 25. So 125 mm is the value for x, and for y 100 minus 100 mm because the second this circular hole is acting below the rectangular plate and it is acting at the center. So our y value will be minus 100 and radius will be, circular diameter is given 25 mm, so radius will be the half of the diameter of this circular solid circular. So radius will be 25 divided by 2. So let's put this value. So x will be our 100 plus 25 and y value will be minus 100 because it is acting downwards below the first rectangular plate, and the radius will be 25 divided by 2, and then click on OK. So this two circular solid circular is added. Now we have to combine these three elements. This is the first, second and third elements we have to combine, or you can subtract this also because we want whole circular hole in this rectangular plate. So for creating the circular plate, we have to subtract these two circular in this rectangular bracket. For subtracting this, again click on operate, then booleans. In this subtract section, click on the subtract. Then we have to subtract these two areas. Click on this. Now first we have to click on this rectangle and click on OK. Now we have to select these two circular which we want to remove from this area, and then click on OK. So we have created two circular hole. Now our next step will be creating a fillet. So fillet radius is given as 10 mm. We have to create one fillet here. For creating the fillets, again back to the create option, then here in option line, and here is option one given is line fillet. Now we have to select two lines where we have to create a fillet. So select the two line and then click on OK. Here fillet radius will be our 10 mm and then click on OK. So this fillet is added. Now we have to combine this, add this fillet element in this element, complete elements. So for adding this element into these elements, so we have option that is operate. Instead of going in this modelings, we have the features area. In this area, if you see that there is option arbitrary, and in this arbitrary there is option through key points. Then we have to select the fillet. So we will select this fillet. So this center point will be selected. So we have selected the three key points of this fillet, and then click on OK. So it will be combined, or you will say that the fillet will be properly adjusted into this element. So if you see that we have to again add this fillet and make them the complete single elements, because this fillet is the second element and this bracket is the first element. So for combining this element, we will go for option operate, then booleans. We have to add this fillet, then area, then we have to select this area, fillet and rectangles, and click on OK. So our fillet is added into this rectangle, and the whole will be our single elements. So this is where we have to adjust the elements. If you have done any geometric, or given the any geometrical relations, or you have drawn this any circle or rectangle line, anything, so make sure that you have to add all these elements, and then you have to make one single elements only, because force will be acting all here only at 10 kilonewton force is load is acting at the rectangular plates. This is why the reason we have to add the whole elements. Now we will go for the meshing. So click on meshing, then size control. We have to adjust the size. So manual size, then area, then all areas, then our element edge length will be 2 mm you can write, or 3 mm as per your convenience, and then click on OK. This area we have written 2 mm because if you done meshing, this complete L bracket rectangles are divided into the number of elements, and the gap will be our 2 mm. So length of this elements will be the 2 mm. Now we will go for mesh tool. In mesh tool, smart size will be on, and then click on mesh, and this select this elements, complete elements selected, and then click on OK. So meshing is done. Click on close. So we have done with the meshing. This is the meshing, and we have given the element size with 2 mm. Now we have to define the load, because in question the load is acting at this circular plate rectangular plate, which is total load will be 10 kilonewton, and it is acting downwards. So click on this load. This is the load. Then we have to define the load, then apply, then structural, then displacement, Then here one option is given on lines. So we have to select the two lines. So we have to select these two lines. And then click on OK. And this should be the fixed. So it should be all degree of freedom, and click on OK. So this will be fixed. We have fixed this plate here, and now we will go for this load. For applying load in this, click on this pressure, because in ANSYS for calculating the maximum stress, we have to go for pressure. But in the actual case, we have to solve by taking the force options. In actual, that is in strength of material, we have seen that force or movement. But in ANSYS, for plotting the load of 10 kN, we have to go in pressure. So in this pressure, we have to click on lines, then select the, now we have to select this two whole side, because two loads is, because the load is acting. So selecting this two side of the circular hole, and then click on OK. So it is asking the load value. So load value will be, in question it is given 10 kN, so it will be 10,000 N. And then click on OK. So load is acting at the circular holes. Now we have completed our full procedure. Now we have to go for the solutions. So click on the solutions, solve current LS, click on OK. It should be yes. So here solution is done, message showing, that means we have completed our full procedure and our procedure is correct. Click on close and it should be close. Now we will go for now displacement result and stress value result. So click on this general processor, then plot result, then here if you see the deformed shape, then deformed plus undeformed, and click on OK. So this is the displacement. If you want to plot this displacement value, or if you want to see the displacement value, for checking the displacement value, you will click on the counter plot, then nodal solutions, then degree of freedom, and click on the displacement vector sum and click on OK. So here the according to the color codes, they have shown the displacement value accordingly. So at the different locations, the different displacement value is to be seen. So in the previous video, I have shown you the two methods of the calculating the or plotting the displacement value and stress value. So this is the first method I am using. Or if you want to see the second method, I will provide you the link in the description box. From there you will see check the value, or you will check the method of this second method for calculating the stress value and displacement value. Now before calculating or plotting the stress value, click on the nodal solution, then click on this stress, then here if you get one stresses, because it is applicable for both ductile materials and brittle material, click on this one miss and click on OK. So this is the stress value, or we have plotted this stress value. The different color codes showing the different stress value. Now, if you want to see the shape, actual shape of this, So click on this control plot and go for style. Click on style, size and shape, and this display of element should be on, and click on OK. Now we click on this isometric view. If you see that we have added this thickness also of 10 mm. This is the thickness of the plate, and this is the actual view of the rectangular plate. If you want to capture this complete this image only, then you will go again for plot control, and here option is given capture image. Then click on this file, then save as, and we will save this. And then click on OK. So our diagram will be saved. I will show you the diagram of this. So this is the previous only we have saved this. So this one is the result for displacement value, and for this is the stress diagram. So different codes showing the stress value. Now if you want to see the animation of this, then again click on plot control, then in this animate, then deformed results option is given, then click on the stress, and our stress will be at the y direction. So click on this y direction and click on OK. So if you see that the different location, the value of the stress is different according to the load we have provided. So if you want to increase the drag this, the its animation speed will be also increased. See, the speed has been increased. You can increase or decrease. For stopping this, click on this stop and then close. For actual view, click on this. So this is, here is the different view is given. If you want to check this, you can check this only. So that this is that is why we have seen one problem, so that you will come to know all this clear, all this main menu elements of this, what is the uses of this all. So I hope you will understand all this carefully. So I will give you one suggestions. If you not understand, don't worry. Make sure you have make one note of this, so that if you will practice again and again, then you will clear all this, how to use this main menu elements in ANSYS APDL. So procedure is to be carried out properly, and you will know all this. So please share, subscribe our channel, and like our video, so that we will provide you the videos related to this ANSYS. So thanks for watching this video.